Hello, and welcome to the Movie Universe. I'm your host, Movie Fan. Today, I will be talking about Red Tails. Red Tails is a story about the 332nd Fighter Wing, better known as the Tuskegee Airmen. Now, I've barely mentioned this movie before when I talked about the Tuskegee Airmen film, and I said that this is a film you need to watch because this film tells a broader picture of their story. It talks about their missions as fighter pilots, how when they got to Europe, they were given hand-me-down planes that were just ready for the junk heap. And of course, they were fighting way in the back. I'm talking areas that were cleared out, where there's barely like any signs of enemy activity. And we all know why that is. But as the story progresses, they start to get real missions, starting with a beachhead where they shoot down over 16 German planes. Because the mission was such a success, this leads to them flying bomber escorts. Because as the movie tells, fighter escorts were not sticking with the bombers. The Germans would just send a few planes their way, and the fighters would just go after them, leaving the bombers to fend for themselves. And of course, the Germans would sweep in and just shoot down every plane they could. Was it true? I wouldn't doubt it, because for most fighter pilots, they wanted to be fighter pilots so they could just shoot down other planes. They didn't want to babysit bombers. Plus, as I've said before when I reviewed the Tuskegee Airmen film, there was a time that they thought the bombers could take care of themselves without fighter escort, which was proven to be very wrong. For the Tuskegee Airmen, they stayed with the bombers until their mission was through. And that is 100% true. They stayed with those bombers. And they are legendary for never losing a bomber. That is a true fact. There's a lot of real facts about the Tuskegee Airmen in this movie, like the most obvious. They had bright red tails on all their planes. It made them stand out amongst the other fighters. The racial issues they encountered, that was true as well. And they brought up something that the movie Tuskegee Airmen never brought up, the fact that people did start to change their minds. Because there's a scene where some bomber pilots are actually buying them drinks for saving their lives. But there are parts of the movie that are total fiction. Like, for instance, there's a pilot in the German Air Force that they nicknamed Pretty Boy because he has a pretty yellow nose painted on his plane. There was no such pilot. In fact, there was a ton of Messerschmitt 109s that had yellow noses. There's also a scene where Joe Little sinks a heavy cruiser with machine gun fire. I don't think I need to tell you that that's impossible. Plus, it never happened. And it's that scene alone that brings up one big piece of fiction in this whole movie. And that's the action itself. It is greatly exaggerated. I'm talking about some of the maneuvers they do in their planes. All that stuff doesn't happen in real life. They've never done anything like that. But that's Hollywood for you. They always take an artistic license in real-life events. And to be fair, I often find that when you have fighter pilot stories that are based off of real events, it often helps to have an enemy that you focus on, although they don't focus on him way too much. The action and the drama are really great in this movie, and it really does help paint a picture as to how great they were as pilots. And it has a great cast as well. One of our main characters, Colonel A.J. Bullard, who is the leader of the 332nd, is played by Terrence Howard. He plays his part so perfectly. He tries to be sensible, and yet he tells it like it is, how they've been given pathetic jobs, and how they're not going to go away, no matter what they throw at them. One of the best pilots they got, Joe Lightning Little, was played by David Olio. Great actor. He really played his part well. He came off as this cocky character who really knew how to fly. And of course, I cannot forget Major Emmanuel Stance, who's played by Cuba Gooding Jr., who many of us will remember was in the movie The Tuskegee Airmen. To be honest, I think this movie is far superior than the Tuskegee Airmen film, because unlike Tuskegee Airmen, this gives a broader version of their story. Because, as I have said before, in the Tuskegee Airmen, they focus way too much on the racial issues, and they don't focus on their acts of heroism at all except for two scenes. For this movie, they focus on their acts of heroism as well as their racial issues. If you've never seen this film, you really should look it up. Believe me, you'll love it. This is Movie Fan, signing off.